Hello from the Bureau. I'm climatologist Robin Duell.
And I'm hydrologist Robert Pippenich. We're here to discuss the climate and water outlook for October to January. So Robin, what's driving the climate this time?
Well, Rob, we have a positive Indian Ocean dipole underway in the Indian Ocean. And we can see that by that cooler than usual water to the northwest of Australia. And when this happens, Rob, higher pressure tends to dominate over Australia, and we typically see warmer and drier conditions in Australia. We also have a tendency towards a negative southern annular mode in the coming months as well, and this also increases the chance of warmer and drier conditions.
Right.
And this is very much reflected in our rainfall outlook for October.
Yeah, it's pretty strong.
It's a strong outlook, with most of mainland Australia likely to see drier than usual days. But if we step forward to the November to January period, that signal, that dry signal, remains in the east, but we do see it becomes very likely, or likely, that we'll see wetter than usual conditions in Western Australia.
So, Robin, why the breakdown of this drying signal as we approach summer?
Well, that positive Indian Ocean dipole and that negative southern annular mode, they're likely to start to decay as we move into this period.
Okay.
So their influence on rainfall will start to reduce as we move into summer. So Rob, with a dry outlook, what does this mean for stream flow?
Yeah, no surprise that we're seeing about 85% of locations likely to have low flows for coming months. But there are a few places, mainly Victoria and up in Queensland, where we will see near median and high flows. And this is because there's some residual wetness in some of the catchments there from winter rainfall, which should influence upcoming flows despite the low rainfall outlook. So Robin, we've talked about rainfall, we've talked about stream flows. How about temperatures? What are we likely to see for coming months? And is that dry outlook likely to have an effect?
That dry outlook is likely to impact on temperatures. With clearer skies more likely, that means it's very likely that days will be warmer than average over the October to December period.
Okay, and how about nights?
Overnight, clear skies increases the chance of cooler than usual nights in the south at this time of the year. And we see that reflected in our October minimum temperature outlook, with parts of southern Australia likely to see cooler than usual nights. So that means there's an increased risk of late season frost in susceptible areas here.
Okay, something to look out for there. Thanks, Robin. That's it from us for now. Our climate and water outlooks are now updated weekly, so head to our website for more information.